Howdy, watch fans. Lux Neophyte here with episode 9. And in this episode, we feature not a watch, but something far less tangible. Join me for a little experiment with the uber trendy and buzzworthy cryptocurrency and my lust for Grand Seiko. Stick around. So, like many of my nutty watch brethren, this watch newbie is slightly more than enamored by Grand Seiko. Some would even say that I am in love with Grand Seikos. And not in that wholesome way Peter Parker loves Mary Jane Watson, as illustrated in Amazing Spider-Man Annual No. 21 from 1987. No, this is darker. This is an obsession. It's like Rod Stewart looking through the blinds in that music video for the song Infatuation. Exactly. That kind of dark. That kind of obsession. And while in front of family and friends I may sit there with a little bit of shame for my obsession, chances are we're the same kind of weird, and you're saying, "I know, right?" at the mention of the Grand Seiko obsession. So, for the last year I have been saving, pinching my pennies, trying to save for that first Grand Seiko, the SBGN 005 Quartz GMT, the Rolex Explorer 2, inspired beauty. And I have watched countless YouTube videos of the watch since its debut in August 2018. So just as a quick recap, the SBGN 005 was part of a trio release for the 20th anniversary of the Caliber 9 Quartz movement. The regular production black dial SBGN 003, the blue dialed SBGN 005, and the limited to 800 yellow night and day ring SBGN 001. Apparently, this marked the first 9F quartz GMT sporting the hyper accurate ticking of the 9F86 movement. The 9F86 boasts a plus minus accuracy of 5 seconds a year. 5 seconds a year. Crazy. So skipping over the more obsessive parts of the story, so there I was, with enough cash to buy a brand new SBGN 005, looking through the Grand Seiko website for the closest retailer. Excitedly, I opened the Grand Seiko website and navigated over to the Grand Seiko Sports Collection, and navigated down past the beautiful watches outside of my grasp. For example, scrolling down past the gorgeous new Hi-Beat SBGJ 237 at almost twice what I have saved, and to the beauty I've obsessed about since 2018. But as I was admiring my soon-to-be Grand Seiko, I felt myself getting pulled up. Up, wheeling the mouse back up to the SBGJ 237. Yes, the one that was more than double the SBGN 005. And then this watch neophyte realized a new and different yearning, smack dab in the middle of a new conundrum. No, not quite an existential crisis, but a struggle between the two adversaries of instant versus delayed gratification. And then I started to think a bit, and since it's been a while since I had attempted a bit of thinking, but pushing on, assisted by frequent breaks and headache pills, I came upon an idea. Forgo the SBGN 005 for now, and delay gratification by saving a while longer for the SBGJ 237. But not only save, why not invest the SBGN money into something that might get me to the SBGJ 237 faster? So here's the challenge. What is the most expedient way of going from the SBGN 005 money to the SBGJ 237 money? Now there's really three options here. I could go out and rob somebody. I could toil and save for another year. Or maybe I can invest the money that I have right now and try to get to that SBGJ 237 money a little faster. Now, given the fact that I couldn't steal a lollipop from a baby, I've tried. Long story. Moving on. There's only one option there. And that's to save? No. Let's try investing the money. Now, there are a ton of options out there depending on the amount of risk one wants to take on. For the risk-averse, there's the traditional savings or investment. A quick peruse through the ING Luxembourg website shows an average annual return of 0 to 2.0%, or investment funds that have an average annual return of 1.5 to 6.0%. And there are more iterations of options out there, from ETFs to money market accounts to a whole litany of stocks, bonds, and derivatives to choose from, covering the entire spectrum of risk. So what route should I take? Well, for me, I took the unorthodox and uber risky road of cryptocurrency, mostly because of the level of gains that I could get, and just plain curiosity. You read enough about cryptocurrency and you watch enough YouTube videos, you quickly realize that the world is split into three categories. Those that are proponents and see it as the future of money, those that see it as a pseudo-pyramid scheme mainly used by the nefarious underbelly of society and the dark web, and the third, those that have no idea or have zero dams to give about the subject. Now, it's important to note that this is not a how-to or advice video. I am simply chronicling a newbie's perspective into cryptocurrency investing for the purpose of funding my Grand Seiko obsession upgrade. So, on January 21st, 2021, I have purchased 3.5 USD in three cryptocurrencies. More specifically, I am now the proud owner of 4,621 Cardano ADA coins, purchased for a total of $1,544.07, including fees of 44 USD. Also, I have bought 0.03207993 Bitcoin for a total of $1,015, including fees of 1490. And lastly, I am the proud owner of 0.84895909 Ethereum Ethers for a total of $1,015, including the fee of $14.90 USD. Oh. You know, with all these decimal points, it really makes it hard for people that aren't very good at math. But I digress. In total, I spent $3,574.07, roughly the tax-inclusive price of the SBGN005 in cryptocurrency, choosing the number one and the number two most valued assets in the cryptocurrency market, and the ADA coin, or the ADA coin, which seems to have quite an interesting promise of the future and even more interesting leader in Charles Hoskinson. Now, since this is a watch channel, I won't go into the details of all these coins, as no doubt there's enough liturgy and videos out there on these three coins alone to inundate Luxembourg's Grund. No, fellow watch fans, this neophyte is going to keep the experiment and objective simple. The objective is to continue to save 300 USD a month by buying 100 USD in BTC, Ethereum, and ADA on the 21st of each month from January 21st until November 21st, 2021. Then use the proceeds to buy a watch for Christmas, if I haven't lost it all. So the question then is, how much will this investment yield by December 21st, 2021? So what do you think? Am I crazy? Should I just go ahead and purchase the SBGN now? Or just save 300 a month and purchase the SBGJ237 after saving for another year like any normal person would? So many questions. Well, let's see how it goes. Here's hoping I don't lose the entire investment and end up with nothing to do but window shop on December 21st. So there you have it, fellow watch fans. Thanks so much for watching this episode. If you found it interesting, hey, please push the like button below or even subscribe to see if Operation Grand Seiko Upgrade will succeed or crash and burn like so many of my other crazy ideas and dreams. Anyways, as we like to say around these parts, whatever you have on your wrist, whether it's a Grand Seiko or a Vostok, you do you. And in the immortal words of the great Humpty Hump of the Digital Underground, do what you like. Peace.